Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play The Secret of Monkey Island Special Edition. I'm your host, That Guy, and, well, it's the first of 2012. I hope you guys have had a happy holidays, because I've had a great time, actually. A lot of very weird things have happened, but, in the end, everything seems to have turned out really well.
Move out of the way, all
right. I don't need to fight.
That's my way through.
Sorry to bother you. I'll be on my way.
We're actually going to do the second task, which is finding missing buried treasure, but we need to first be able to click on this damn fork. Now, yeah, I had a pretty good time. It was quite enjoyable. We're going to look at the map.
I think I've been had. This is no map. It looks like dancing lessons.
Okay. Yeah, so basically these are the directions to the treasure. Yeah, he's right, it does sound like a dance, but these are actually the directions to the treasure. Now, these are all relative to how you look at the game. So, back would be away from, into the background. Left is left of the screen, right is the right of the screen. The only catch is, when it says back, and there's multiple choices like this, they always mean the right one. Okay? So, I don't know how they expect you to know that, but yeah, they could have told you that. You can always pick up the plants, which you actually need to do anyway. What was it, back? I got this rundown somewhere. I decided to actually give a shot at just just doing this part at least, just to make sure I didn't screw it up, because, yeah, it's been a long time since I've actually done LPing. It's been like a week or something like that, so, yeah. But as I was saying, New Year's, one of my friends proposed to his girlfriend, and of course, yes, she did say yes. So congrats to him. It was a pretty interesting night. I did have to work on New Year's Eve, so I only showed up like, you know, 10 o'clock when I should have been there at like, you know, 7 or something. But yeah, apart from that, yeah, it was a great night. I actually, just to further explain what happened, I went to the casino in Sydney. Some of you know that I live in Australia,
lost treasure
Sydney.
Of Melee Island. This carefully reproduced piece of Melee Island history has delighted thousands of would-be pirates and their families for generations. Remember, there are other pirates on this island.
That will steal from you.
So go easy on the treasure. Leave some for the next person.
But, I hope you guys don't mind that I actually go into this way of the screen, so it just seems so much easier to do this way.
Well, this shouldn't take too long.
Yeah, right. But, basically, yeah, at the casino, we had a,
Hours pass.
A charity event where we were gambling and trying to win money for our favorite charities.
Hey, now, I think I hit something.
The charity I played for was,
Oh boy! It's a t-shirt!
Yeah, it is a great
one. Not my size, but a nice one nonetheless. Well, I guess I should put all this dirt back now.
Yes, you should. Basically, yeah, I chose the Starlight Foundation, which I raised about $15,000 for. Just shy of that, actually. This is all money provided by, the casino, so all you gotta do is like basically register as well as other people, and you can go and try to win. Oh, that's right, because that way you can actually go and try to win money for the selected charity, but there is a catch to it. I'm not gonna tell you guys what the catch is because it's not relevant to anything, except for the fact that you normally can't do this. I'm not saying it's illegal, I'm just saying like it's not available to everyone. I guess you could say I know some people to even begin this kind of adventure. So yeah, and of course I have to be a legitimate organization. You can't just say the foundation of saving that guy from poverty or something stupid like that, I guess. Yeah. I forgot what I was going to say. So it turns out that the map is actually a real map after all, which is kind of weird. Some people wouldn't have expected that. Oh, we haven't activated this yet. I could have sworn that we have, though. Oh, we might as well just do it anyway.
Hello? Anybody in here? Hello?
You know, bad things could happen to a person in a dark, deserted alley like this one. And at this time of night, nobody would be around to see it.
Oh crap, are we gonna die? Did you hear something back in here too? I think so. Well, we have got a sword, so we could take it.
Bad things happen to people who sneak up on other people from behind.
So, you're gonna give me a little attitude, huh?
Give you a lot more than that. Name.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm a mighty pirate.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, Peepwood.
Threepwood.
Threepwood.
Guybrush Threepwood.
Guybrush Threepwood. That guy.
Whatever your name is, listen. I'm the sheriff around here. Sheriff Fester Shinetop. Take it
from
me.
Sounds familiar.
This is a bad time to be visiting Melee Island. A very bad time. My advice to you is to find somewhere else to take your vacation.
You take your vacation somewhere else as well.
Somewhere safer.
Somewhere you don't get killed.
Boy, I feel much better knowing there's an officer of the law around.
Which is ironic, because we're actually going to have to steal something now, so... Yeah. So, we've done two of the free trials. What we actually need to do for here is... Just to give you guys a bit of background, this trial actually took me the longest to figure out when I first played the game, because I had no bloody idea how to do this. So...
You gotta get me out of here! I'm a victim of society!
Or a prisoner of society!
Blah. Hey, it's hard to keep my breath minty fresh when there's nothing to eat in here but rats.
Which I gotta... I guess is kind of true as well, so...
Talk to Death Breath? No thanks.
If I remember correctly, it is actually possible to talk to him anyway, but... I think you need to go here first? Basically,
hey, where'd you go?
In this game, it is possible to,
way across the island
play the game for
a reservation with the Swordmaster.
You just need to think laterally, like, instead of logically.
And when I come back, whew, you're gone. See if I ever do you a favor again. What do you want?
I could really use a breath mint.
Whew. You're telling me. Here, take one. Please. Take the whole roll.
Because obviously they had breakfast back then. No problem.
What else do you want?
That's what I want. Be nice to the people.
I think I'd just like to browse.
Yeah.
Hey, this ain't no boutique.
Don't make me turn you into pixel form. Yeah, that's all we needed anyway. Okay, so, can do, see him, and yeah, excuse this, I'm just, oops, give, to prisoner, there we go.
Oh, Grago Mint, how refreshing.
Jamaican or something.
Thanks.
Nice.
So, have you come to release me?
Who are you?
My name is Otis. At least I think it is. I've been in here so long I can hardly remember.
Can't blame me for that.
You gotta get me out of here before I lose my mind completely. Can't you see? I'm innocent.
But why are you in jail if you're innocent?
I was framed. I didn't touch the stupid flowers.
Okay. That sounds stupid, but...
The yellow Konish in Dormy flowers in the forest.
That's what we picked up before.
A lot to pick them.
Yes, it is.
Well, keep it stiff. Up
I don't really get it either when you think about it. Basically, I don't know how you figure it out, but striking yellow color. But basically. What I did, like, after getting completely fed up, is combining items. And one thing you can do is combine the meat with the flour. Which sounds stupid, but for some reason, it actually, that's the reason why it's illegal, apparently. Because the yellow flowers is, supposed to be some sort of a knock-you-out kind of thing, I think, something like that. Or... Something like that, anyway. Excuse me for a second while I do this again. Oh, they actually make sound as well. Deadly piranha poodles, huh? Here, eat this. Oh, got a short one. Oh, no. Ripped in one. Okay. And they pass out.
Important notice. These dogs
are not dead. They're only sleeping. No animals were harmed during the production of this game. I'm sure no it is. Let's see what it looks like in... Oh, God. That's horrible. Yeah, let's go in then. Okay, so the item that we're going to steal is actually in this manor. Now, the funny thing about it is...
A priceless Ming.
How come there's no sound? Oh, maybe they
don't recognize the man.
They
but
probably
he has a
didn't
great
actually
hat.
Put anything in there.
For reading now.
The item that you need to actually steal, I believe, is in this room. Yeah, should be in this room.
This door appears
but
to be locked.
You can't get in. So, what you need to do. Strange, all the sound just seems to have cut out altogether. Is it just me? Please don't let it just be me. Okay. Oh, actually, let's go outside first. Just double check if it's just me. Not that it is. No, it might just be me. Oh, actually, no, there is sound. I don't know what I'm worried about, but... I can't hear anything.
This looks like a job for Fester Shinetop.
Nah, there should be talking there. Something's wrong. What's wrong, though? I'll be back in 1 second. Hey, everybody. Turns out somehow my sound got muted, so I'm gonna have to look into that later, but let's get back to it. Basically, what's happened is a cutscene's gonna activate, and I will have no control of Guybrush for quite a while, so just pay attention to the sound effects it makes, as well as along the bottom left, because you'll see a lot of actions which are going to happen, but that's not actually me, because obviously I'm not even moving, so... Excuse me for 1 minute. It's Vaz. Hypnotized, quarrelsome rhinoceros.
No, not the red button.
Push red button. Look at tremendous yak.
It's a big, ugly, hairy yak wearing some wax lips.
Push tremendous, dangerous
I can't
looking
move
yak.
It.
Can't move it. Okay, fine.
I can't move it.
Can't pull it either. Oh, I got a staple remover. Okay. This isn't me moving either, okay? This is just a computer doing it automatically. Walk to books.
I'll
manual style. Not that we really know
nuts.
What it is. But, yeah. Come out, get a book, walk back in. Wax lips. Don't know what we're going to do with that, but okay.
Gophers!
Just happens to be gopher repellent there. Another gopher! Gopher horde! It's a funny little man. Okay, so there's a fabulous idol.
Beautiful.
But there's a lock on it, which is what they're trying to say.
Uh-oh.
Heavy chair. Got the heavy chair. Use. Heavy chair with Sheriff. Crash. Why are there so many fireworks?
That
why is there
a for a while.
Okay, so...
If only I had a file, I could get the idol.
What we need to do is get, a file so we can get the idol, as he just said, which I don't know why I'm repeating that for. But, yeah. Ironically, Excuse me, yawning time. Ironically, the store doesn't actually have a file, so. But of course, next place you'd probably look for a file is someplace that they actually probably need one, which would be the prison. Would you happen to have a file?
You think I'd be in here if I did? All I have is this carrot cake my Aunt Tilly made. You can have that if you bring me something to get rid of these rats. I can't stand carrot cake.
Now, you'd think that he'd understand that the carrot cake is, if he doesn't like it, then what's the point in giving it to him? So, rats, apparently go for repellent is good enough for the rats. So, give that to the prisoner.
Hey, this is my work on the rats. Thanks. Here's the cake.
Otherwise, he probably would have given the cake to the guards and then, yeah. Basically, there's a cake, and apparently it's heavy. So what you do is, I think you have to use the cake. Oh yeah, there's a file in the cake. So that's all you need to do. And yeah, that's pretty much all we needed to do, actually, ironically. Just to go there, understand that we need a file to break a lock, because of course an idol would probably be locked. And yeah. Off we go. I think you need to. Where is it here?
This door appears to be locked.
So, yeah, activate auto scene now.
I got the file.
Where's the sheriff? He's still here. Manual Star Wars Shredder. The thing is, I can change it to the old school version, but then you don't have the sound, so but basically you can see all the things coming up at the bottom of the screen, which all the things it picks up and puts down and stuff like that. But I prefer to play this because I like the perfect. Oh, we got a crap kicked out of us.
That was a close one.
Yes it was.
At least I got the idol.
But I'm not done with you yet.
Uh-oh.
Thought you could get out of here with the idol of many hands, did you?
Mm-hmm.
Look, I can explain.
So can I. You poisoned the governor's pet poodles.
They're just sleeping.
Broke into her house.
Do you like how we just, like, walk a few steps, then turn around?
And stole one of her most valuable pieces of art.
No, you've got it all wrong.
Oh, really? Well, let's hear your explanation.
It's pretty much all going to end up the same way, but let's do the... It belongs in a museum!
It belongs in a museum!
You haven't changed it at all, kid.
What's going on here?
Why do you have an English accent?
I'm making off with your idol, Governor. He says it belongs in a museum.
That's right, it does.
What?
You heard me, Fester. The real question is, how did he get in here while you were on guard?
That's a good question.
Oh, just go away, Fester. I can handle this.
I'll deal with you later.
Sorry about him. He's new. I'm Governor Marley. Governor Elaine Marley.
How do you look in? Well, that's not too bad, really. Like, in this, I think she looks better in this form than probably in this form, but I don't know. But then again, we look stupider in this form as opposed to in this form. Doesn't really make a difference.
Relax, Mr. Threepwood. I know why you're here.
I bet you do.
Believe me, you're not the first who's tried. Although I have to admit, not many get as far as you have. My lookout told me of your arrival. I've wanted to meet you ever since I heard your fascinating name.
It is pretty fascinating, isn't it?
Tell me, Guybrush, why do you want to be a pirate?
It's ironic, because like yeah, we haven't really said why we want to be
Your
a pirate
face
at all.
Is too
soft.
Sweet.
Oh. Deeds aren't even going to make the proper sense. Maybe it will.
Well, you're obviously not in the mood for idle chit-chat, are you?
Nope.
I suppose you've got many more exciting things to do? I won't take up any more of your time, Mr. Threepwood.
You're going to let us just walk out with it?
Bubble! Riffenkiff! Twinkly? I really wish I knew how to talk to women.
Yeah, you're not even making proper words. Okay.
Where do you think you're going, Froom Wade?
You know, yeah. It's not too late for us to make up and be friends.
Yeah. And it's also not too late for me to kill you and still make it to the bar for happy hour. Hand over your sword.
Uh-oh.
This is the end of the road, my little pantalooned pal. Your troublemaking days on Melee Island are over. My plans for the governor are far too important and much too near completion to risk letting a would-be pirate like you get in the way. So long, Mr. Spicecake, or Droopface, or whatever your name is.
So long. Okay.
This might actually turn out to be a pretty good day.
It is actually possible to die in this game, but it's not exactly that much of a deal. You know, you're probably thinking to yourself, like, yeah, can I get to any of these? But it takes like, I don't know, 5-10 minutes for the character to die. And I know it's an achievement, but it's like in the Xbox version, I believe it is. But yeah, it's not a big of a deal. But basically, we're tied to the idol and we can't get out of here. We can't move.
We can't reach it.
There's not even anything that will work against it, honestly.
No staples to be removed.
Basically, how do you make yourself become detached from the idol? Or how can we move the idol? Well, that's pretty simple, really, because, as I said, you do need to think in laterally. Just take it, really, and that's it. You just
I guess
off.
I'll be needing a sword. And this one will do.
Yeah, pretty much that's it, really. They got away!
What was that? I'm so confused.
Hey! What are you doing just standing around? The governor's been kidnapped!
What? By whom?
LeChuck's got her on that ship that just sailed off. He caught her alone when she came down here to rescue you. I'm afraid we've seen the last of her.
Well...
So
yeah.
Where were you this whole time? Sleeping?
Hey, I'm a lookout, not a bodyguard.
That's kind of true. It's different. Yeah.
I'll go get a crew and a ship and go rescue her.
We'll save her.
That's not gonna be easy, you know.
Oh, fine, we won't save.
LeChuck's taken the governor back to his hideout on Monkey Island. I'm afraid that no pirate on this island is brave enough to follow him there. But hey, good luck. Oh, yeah, I almost forgot. They left this note. You can have it, but I don't think you'll like what it says.
Oh, Governor, why did you have to risk your life for me? Maybe you cared for me more than I thought. Just as I now realize how much I care for you. It's my fault the Governor's in this mess, and I swear I'll get her out of it. Even if I have to sail to Monkey Island myself to get her.
Well, that's the whole point of this game. So. Let's Let's just have a look at the note.
Attention, pirates of Melee. Your governor is alive and well and by my side as she was always meant to be. If you try to find us, you will only meet with horrifying disaster. Yours truly, Captain LeChuck.
Okay, that will wrap up this episode, unfortunately. Because now that we've done the free trials, we can basically call ourselves proper pirates. And why is this just random music on? But I do hope that you enjoyed watching. Welcome everyone to 2012 as well. I do hope you have a good holidays while we're here. And yeah, as per usual, take care of yourselves out there, yeah?